There's a very clear symbiosis between really any sort of opposing groups. So on the far right, you would have neo-Nazi white supremacist groups. On the far left, you would have anti-racist or anti-fascist groups. And, you know, both sides are kind of sworn to the eradication of the other. But without that other side, they really got, like, no wind in their sails. They have nothing to live for. So, for example, in my skinhead days, there were anti-racist skinheads who called themselves Skinheads Against Racial Prejudice. And they had made it known that they were there to smash Nazis, and they were, you know, you wouldn't dare show your face as a Nazi if they were in town. Well, in Milwaukee, there was a few of them, but they were kind of weak, and there wasn't, they really couldn't give us a decent fight. So we lived for, like, chasing those guys down and beating them up. But because they honestly couldn't give us a challenge, we would regularly, like, pile in vans and drive out to Minneapolis or down to Chicago, where there was a lot more anti-racist skinheads, and they're a lot bigger and tougher. And we, like, that gave us a reason to exist. It didn't discourage us. It, like, it validated our entire narrative that there were these communists to fight, and that, you know, we had to be out there fighting them. And without that enemy, I don't think we would have grown anywhere near as strong as we did or as fast as we did. And today you can see that very clearly as well, not just in the sense of, like, face-to-face street confrontations, but primarily today in social media and in kind of news outlets as well.